Researchers around the world are scrambling to find a vaccine against the new virus that exploded out of China. Just days after Chinese scientists shared the virus's genetic code, researchers at the National Institutes of Health were engineering a key vaccine ingredient. Their target is a spike-like protein on the virus's surface. NIH is working with biotech company Moderna to manufacture the vaccine.
It's a very rapid way of discovering new applications because it's all based on digital technology.
Injecting a piece of the virus's genetic code in a vaccine instructs cells to make the target protein. That puts the immune system on alert for the real virus. It's a newer and far faster way of making vaccines without using the virus itself.
We make this without living organisms. This is all a chemical process, nearly all of it. And so you can condense it and you can make it efficient in scale and in time relative to traditional ways of making vaccine.
Moderna is just one of several companies working on a vaccine in the United States. There are other efforts worldwide in places like Australia and France. At the Pasteur Institute in Paris, they're piggybacking on the measles vaccine, working to mix into it protection against the new coronavirus. Experts say the response from around the world has been swift.
This would be the fastest that I've seen movement from identification of a virus to generation of an approach to initial synthesis of a vaccine.
This is the third dangerous coronavirus to cause a surprise outbreak in 20 years, after two others named SARS and MERS. Experts say they don't believe it will be the last.
The ability to use this particular vaccine against other coronaviruses is something that will definitely be tested, because the goal, of course, is to have one on the shelf that you could use against the next virus that might emerge, as well as the one that we're currently dealing with.
For now, officials are trying to stop the virus's spread by isolating the sick, and doctors are looking for experimental treatments. Kathy Young, Associated Press.